In the previous video, we have published an event view with high-resolution data while the wind turbine was running. In this video, we are going to incorporate that data into our Power BI report. We are also going to learn how to create drill-through report pages, which can be then opened from other visuals throughout the report. Let's do it! Let's begin by adding the turbine running data into our Power BI report. For convenience, we will use the recent sources dropdown from the Home tab of the ribbon. Before we join this table into the data model, we have to add a date column based on the timestamp. So let's do it. First, let's click on the Transform Data in the Home ribbon to open the query editor. Now let's select the table Turbine Running Data and select the timestamp column. In the ribbon, navigate to the Add Column tab and choose Date, Date Only. This will create a new column called Date. Now let's click on Close and Apply, and then navigate to the Model section on the left side. You can join the turbine running data to Date on the Date field. And later, turbine running data to turbine information on the wind turbine field. Now let's create a drill-through report page for wind farm details. So let's begin by creating a new report page by clicking the new page icon in the bottom of the screen. Name this page Wind Farm. On the visualizations pane on the right, drag Wind Farm from turbine information onto the drill through fields. This configures drill through to this page from any visual that uses the wind farm as a category. Ensure the Keep All Filters is off. This will prevent additional filtering of the page. Notice also that a back button now exists in the top left corner. So this can be used by Control and click from within Power BI desktop, or can be clicked on normally if the report is published online. As you can see on the trend on the screen, the wind turbine power is strongly affected by the wind speed. Now that we have high-resolution running data available, we can create a line chart to show this trend for the wind turbines in each farm. So first, let's add a line chart to the page and select wind speed from turbine running data for the axis, wind turbine from turbine information for the legend, and power from turbine running data for values. Remember to make sure that the summarization is set to average for power. So the trend that we just created shows the expected power curve, but you can notice that the trend is very noisy and makes the different turbines difficult to distinguish from one another. Also, using power for the values makes it kind of difficult to distinguish between a poorly performing turbine and a turbine with a lower rated power. So let's make a few improvements to this trend. So first of all, we will configure the line chart to use wind speed bins or groups instead of the raw wind speed value to address the first issue. To do it, let's right-click on wind speed in the field section and choose new group. So let's set the bin size to 0.5 to of 0.5 meters per second and then click OK. This creates a new field named wind speed bins, which can be used as the axis for the line chart. So we said that the second issue is that it is difficult to distinguish between a poorly performing turbine and a turbine with a lower rated power. Before we address this issue, let's first notice how the chart appears when showing a wind farm that has many different models. To do this, let's change the drill through field from wind farm to mid mesa wind farm. The turbines in this wind farm have rated powers between 1,500 and 3,000 kilowatts, which makes it difficult to see which turbines are underperforming. To solve this issue, the power could be shown as a percentage of the rated power. For this case, the calculation has already been performed in the PI system and is available as the capacity factor. If this were not already in place, a new measure could have been created. So let's update the chart to use capacity factor for values instead of power. Remember to set the summarization to average and format the column to percentage. So now let's add a title to the page by adding a value card using the field wind farm from turbine information. To test the drill through, let's navigate to the wind generation overview page and right-click on one of the bars for the energy by wind farm funnel chart. Now let's choose drill through wind farm details, and the page that was just created should appear. All right, so now let's copy the date slicer from the wind generation overview onto the wind farm details page. A prompt to sync visuals should appear, which will let the slicer stay in sync across the pages. Let's choose sync so that the pages will share the slicer. To sync slicers at a later point or disable syncing, you can open the Sync Slicers pane from the View tab of the ribbon. This concludes the video on incorporating the running data into the Power BI report. To create this report, we first loaded the turbine running data into our report. We then created a new report page for wind farm details. We set the page to use drill through, and we added some visuals to the report. Thanks for watching.